Welcome on board this beautiful Sanlorenzo SL104 that was built in 2011. Today I'm in La Spezia and I invite you to this tour of the boats and all its details. Here we are on the aft deck with the loose furniture lounge. They're all from Minotti, an Italian design brand. And what you can see is that you can arrange them all as you wish because the teak deck is completely going through and there's no fixed furnitures. And then further off, we have the garage that hides two hydraulic sledges, one for a tender and the other one for the jet ski. And also there you have a shower coming out and of course the hydraulic passerelle. It's quite a windy day and there's a lot of waves coming in, but thanks to the zero speed hydraulic stabilizers, we're actually sitting here quite comfortably. And you can see that later also how that system operates, but you see, to the comparison, this boat is actually rolling quite a lot next to us and we're actually sitting quite comfortable. Yeah, and then here you have the engine room access through this door on the starboard side, which we will show in a minute. Then of course the main access to the saloon with the sliding doors, and then here you have also a nice door that hides this access to the flybridge with the teak deck stairs. So this gives one really sleek looking surface. And then we enter through the main saloon door and we have immediately what you can see is this olive tree wooden floor. Of course, the panoramic windows, big windows that actually allow a lot of natural light coming in. And then the Italian design sofa lounge, the book of Breezy Yachting, How to Sell Your Yacht, not to miss. There's also available for download. And then we discussed already with a client that it might be a good idea to fit here a mini bar. I think that's really a good idea. What we have here also is an ice maker hidden behind that nice leather feature panel. And then we have a TV on a rise and fall mechanism. In those drawers, you have some storage and also some drawers coming out for the remotes. And then we have the dining table arrangement, which is kind of in the center. And I think you can even fit a much larger table, of course, because again, here, all is loose furnitures and not fixed. So if you would like, you can of course completely rearrange. And then there's the access to the galley and the crew area. There's the guest access. And also there is another access to this L-shaped galley, which we will see in a minute. And then on both sides, we have a automatically operated door to give access to the side decks. It's actually really comfortable by the touch of a button. And also, this we have on the other side, which is here. Just quickly gonna show you. So on both sides, you can actually enter the side decks. And then now we go forward, but before we do that, we have the day head, which is the toilet for the guests. And it's also beautifully designed. And then on the right side, we have some more storage lockers. And then here, that's the other access to the galley, to the main galley, because the crew has its own little galley downstairs. And of course, lots of storage for cold space. Entering the master cabin, we have two lockers with hangers and drawers coming out. And then also on the right side, we have again some more storage and drawers. Left and right of the bed, you also have more storage. And then you have some nice bedside tables and lamps. And of course, one main feature of this SL104 is the big window to enjoy the sea view. You can overlook the sea beautifully. You can also completely black it off. There's two, you see two rails. So one is just to give shades and the other one is to really black it off. And then you also have a skylight that allows lots of natural light coming in. There's the other TV And again, worth mentioning is the storage underneath the bed. And then here you have a cosmetic table opening with some mirrors inside. And here you have the beautiful Italian designed master ensuite shower. I think it's really a beautiful design piece. And also this surface here from marble is kind of cut to the edges. So it looks very light, very, very designy. And then the toilet with natural light coming in. I really like this light and airy design. I think it's really beautiful. Also nice to mention is this technical area here in the walkway that can serve as a storage, but also gives access to all the technical appliances for the captain and to store tools. And then we go into the galley where you have the big fridge and freezer combination. Again, very design, very beautiful Italian design. And below are the freezers. Then over here you have some drawers. You have the Miele induction professional equipment, of course the oven, and then the hob extractor fan. You have some drawers again, and then you have also a dishwasher that is here. Space for your coffee machine. There's another drawer, microwave, and then down here is the wine cooler for all the drinks. It's quite important on a boat. And then you have also a sliding door and then access to the wheelhouse, which you're going to see in a minute. As I said, here is the other door to open and close by the touch of a button, which gives you easy access to both side decks. Going down to the crew area, it's a nice stairway. And you can also see this is the door to give you access to the guest area, which you're going to see in a minute. But that's very nice for the service. So the crew can basically quickly access all the cabins, make the beds, make the sheets, clean the showers, and then back off again once the guests are coming in from the swim. So they really can embrace the concept of an invisible crew. The crew itself, they also have a very large fridge-freezer combination. They have their own little galley down here so they can cook for themselves something. Then you have three spacious cabins. This is the captain cabin with a single bed. And then you have two cabins with bunk beds, spacious ensuite shower and toilet combination. And then also here a little sink, some storage, then you have the tumble dryer and washing machine combination. There's some more storage behind there and in the floors. And then of course here another cabin with bunk bed and ensuite, where the crew has really good area and space for themselves, which is very important if you have a want to have an enjoyable experience, to have a happy crew, then you also a happy owner. Now let's go from the saloon down to the guest area. The guest cabins, there's this beautiful staircase. And then here, as I show you in the video, there's the access also for the crew. So let's gonna close this door. And then you have a nice corridor. With some storage locker, store the cleaning products or bed sheets or whatever. And also under each bed, there's a lot of storage. And this is a beautiful guest cabin with a double bed. And you have the locker and some storage besides each bed and some nice little bedside furniture. And then here also a nice feature piece, mirror, which you can actually slide. I think that's a beautiful design touch to allow to watch out to the sea or allow in some natural light. And also here, a very nice haptic on this sink with beautiful marble and a generous shower. And then here we have also a toilet with lots of natural light. Then we go from this double cabin to the twin bed arrangement, which is a bit smaller but still feels generous. There's also lots of storage on both sides. You have a locker and then beautiful bathroom as well. Design surfaces, some storage behind all the panels. And then we go forward into the VIP, or I would call it rather a second master cabin, because it is really generous and actually offers nearly the same amount of space and definitely a lot of storage as well, with this walk-in wardrobe where you have also a porthole that is now closed. Lots of drawers. Then you have on the starboard side this table desk with some drawers. Let's say the cosmetic table. Also here some cabinets to put more clothes and a little fridge if you're getting thirsty during the night. And then here's some more lockers for all the things you need in the bathroom. A shower with a beautiful bench made out of marble. And then again, natural light coming in through this big porthole. And behind each mirror, you have again some storage. So I think this can be very nice for cabin boat arrangement if you don't need five cabins. Although this cabin could be converted into two cabins if you would spend about 150,000 euros. We have that quoted basically from Sanlorenzo. They could do that work. But I think it's a very generous boat if you let it stay with four cabins. Coming from the saloon, we have a sliding door that hides between this feature painting piece of art, but also it reveals the access to the crew area and the galley. And then you can go up as well to the raised pilot house that is the command central for the captain. Here you have all the storage for the charts, which I'm not gonna open up because then the computer will fall over. The captain installed himself a nice printer. And of course, here you have all the technical equipment, which is the VHF. This is the autopilot. You have the keyboard to control the Raymarine G series. You have the wind indicator. You have the hydraulic bow and stern thrusters, of course, engine controls, multifunction engine displays. You have the trim tab indication. You have the zero speed stabilization system, where you can see now the stabilization at work. This alarm is actually just a little sensor that gives the oil pressure and oil level, not the pressure, oil level, which will be fixed. As well as in the second week of May, we are now in the first week of May, engine and generator service will be done. So the boat is really ready for the season, ready to go. And then here you have the management system of Sanlorenzo, which is a touchscreen system. And then you have the camera CCTV to see your engine room status and of course the access to the boat, also to maneuver. And this little thing here is not to launch some rockets, but actually the fire system. So if there would ever be an incident, you can remotely launch and can shut down any fire that comes up in the engine room. But it looks like you could actually launch some starships. And then, of course, we have the engine levers. It has the MTU engines, the big 16V, and with each 2,400 horsepower. That can propel the boat to 29 knots top speed. Nice classic style steering wheel, and of course the spaceship command seat from Bezenzoni with some buttons to control the height and tilt of the backrest. And then here for the spectators or the family, you can have some nice sofas, lots of storage as well. And then through this sliding door, we can go up to the flybridge, which you can open with this sliding. And here comes the sun. Beautiful, wow, look at this weather. So we have some clear panels, some flexible panels that you can actually have installed during navigation. So you protect it from the wind, which is quite comfortable. And here on the helm station at the flybridge, we have everything repeated. Trim tabs, thrusters, engine levers, the horn. Yeah. And here on the flybridge, we have everything repeated. We have the bow thruster, stern thruster, hydraulic, engine levers, steering wheel, trim control, autopilot, VHF, speaker. We have the interphone to talk between the boat, like the between. We have the intercom system to talk between the engine room and the control station here. Engine controls, Raymarine repeater, rudder indicator, and of course all the important gorgeous compass showing you the direction where to go to the next bay. And then over here we have a nice little sofa arrangement, some storage, and then going further aft, we have a beautiful design outside table furniture. This owner has a little gym outside, alfresco gym, with some loose gym equipment, which of course you can rearrange or well, take out of the boats depending on how you want to set it up. And here we have some sunbathing. Again, this is all loose furniture, so you can completely rearrange if you want to put a large sunbathing cushion, so you have space for 8 people to sunbathe, then of course you can do that. So this is really completely up to you and how you want to arrange it. What's a nice design centerpiece is this kitchen. And then we have the door that goes down the aft area. And one nice thing to mention is that there is a shower inside. You can open this up and then you have a rubber shower, which I think is a funny feature to have on a boat. And you can tuck that away nicely and close it off again. And here you have, of course, a nice bimini that can give you some shade from the Mediterranean sun. And all in all, this is quite a spacious, generous flybridge arrangement. What I also wanted to show you is how does this kitchen top work. There's a hidden button which is below here, and when you press it you can actually open up this hidden kitchen and it reveals a Miele teppanyaki grill top with a stainless steel sink. Everything is in brushed stainless steel. You have hot and cold water tap where you can actually clean everything, wash your hands, all some veggies, and put them on the grill. To close it, of course, you need to press the hidden button again, which is good when you know where it is. And then you can slide this completely closed. And of course, down here, there's some storage with a fridge and some more storage. And then on the other side, there I can reveal to you a TV, which you can open like this. And then you can also enjoy watching some TV. Now, as promised, we're gonna go to the engine room. There's a little engineer's sink to wash your hands off the grease, the backup steering alarm, and then you also have an air conditioning. Coming down, I'm 1.88 meters, so I don't have to wash my head. It's actually neat, but not too tight. And then you have the two boilers. Down here, we see the frequency converters that have been retrofitted, which means you can also cruise in the States. And it's very practical because whatever frequency or voltage you have in the port, it doesn't matter because it all converts to the right one. And also it protects the boat from any power surge or anything If the frequency drops or the voltage drops, it doesn't matter because it's protecting all the electrical equipment. Here we have all the main switches, the complete switchboard of the boat, storage area for tools as well. Now we're passing the main bilge and fire pumps to the engine room where we have the two MTU's 16V engines living and breathing fire, both of them 2,400 horsepowers and 1,181 hours. Down there are the fuel filters. Then on this side, we have the hydraulic system for the stabilization units. And back there, there's another hydraulic unit, and then the PTOs that actually drives the hydraulic from the engines when they're running. And then on this side, we have the two generators, Kohler, each 45 kilowatts. One has 1,800 hours, the other has 2,200 hours. Back there is the aircon system with the pressure pumps and the central chiller units. We have a 450 liters power water maker, the hydraulic units for the passerelle and the garage, and the hydraulically operated sledges for the tender and jet ski. Good access to maintain the passerelle, which is always important because they are quite, well, they're like little princesses and need some maintenance from time to time. And then this is the power pack switchboard for the hydraulic stabilization system and thrusters. Then you have the PTOs on the engines that when the engines are running, you create the hydraulic pressures for the stabilizations and the from the engines, but you can also create it, of course, with the generators or the shore power, which we are doing right now. And this is the power, the hydraulic switchboard, basically the valves for stern and bow thruster, and some storage for tools. And up here is the big ventilation system to feed some fresh air into the engine room. And then down here, the gearboxes with the shafts going through. And then here you have the shaft seals that there's no water coming inside. And everything is really clean and tidy, well-maintained. I think you can really see this opening up. Also the bilges, everything, there's really all properly maintained. And there's nothing to hide. There are the seawater filters. Yeah, so that's the tour of the engine room. I hope you enjoyed watching the tour of this Sanlorenzo SL104 built in 2011. If you want to get in touch, just send a WhatsApp by pressing the button below. Also, don't miss the virtual tour further below on the website where you can click through the whole boat and explore every corner of it. We can send you the PDF. The boat is in La Spezia in Italy, and we can arrange a visit anytime. She's being serviced, ready for the season. So if you're looking for such a nice 100 feet plus boat with the owner's cabin on the main deck, don't hesitate. It's worth a visit, and I'd be happy to arrange it for you. I'm Cornelis Kistler, founder of BreezeYachting.Swiss.